Hello viewers, welcome to my channel TL Technical Solutions. As you know, Government of J&K has issued an order for government employees. As per the order, all the employees of J&K have to submit progress report of every month by or before 7th of next month on EPMS portal. Today, I am going to show you how to register yourself on EPMS portal and how to submit monthly progress report online. Without wasting any time, let's get started.
For more videos related to government employees, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications of those videos.
First of all, you have to download an Android app on your mobile phone. To download the app, you have to open the Google Play Store and type Send Us in the search bar. S-A-N-D-E-S. Install this app on your mobile phone. I have already installed, so I will directly open it. You have to give certain permissions to this app. Just tap on allow. To get yourself registered, you have to provide your mobile number, which is linked with your CPIS database. Click on the I agree checkbox and then tap on Get OTP. Just click here and then click on the Allow button. Now you have to create your profile. If you want, you can upload your profile picture. I will skip this. Type your name, select your gender and click on Next. You can sync your contact list. I'm going to skip this. I have received the welcome message. Now I will close this app and open Chrome browser. Just type this address on address bar epm.jk.gov.in. As soon as EPMS website will open, you have to scroll down and get yourself registered. Click on register/login button. To get registered first time, click on the new user. Now you have to enter your CPIS ID and click on get details. Now verify your name, CPIS ID, designation, department and office. If there is any discrepancy, you can contact your DDO and get your details updated. I have verified my details. My details are correct, so I will click on send OTP. OTP generated and sent to registered mobile on Sandus. Now you have to click on the home button of your phone and open Sandus app. I have already received my OTP. Click here, copy OTP. But I will tell you one thing here, this will copy only 6 digits. And maybe your OTP is consisting of 8 digits. Just close this app and get back to your EPM website. Now switch back to EPMS portal. Now I'm back to EPMS website. I will scroll down. I'll paste my OTP and I'm going to enter 2 more digits as I receive it and click on the submit OTP button. Now you have to create password for EPM website. After entering your password, you have to click on the register button. Now I have received the message, registered successfully, please log in. Now you have to close this and go back to the EPMS login page. Enter your username, which is your CPIS ID, and password, which you created recently. Enter your verification code as shown in above image and click on login. You have to check your details. The next thing to do is to enter CPIS ID of your reporting officer, which will be provided to you by your DDO. After entering his or her CPIS ID, you have to click on Get Details. I have not submitted any report yet. As soon as you will submit your report, the red color will automatically turn into green. And green button means your report has not been reviewed. Now I am going to tell you how to submit a report. Firstly, you have to log in. After logging into the website, to submit your monthly report, you have to click on three lines menu button. Click on Submit Activities and then click on Submit Report. Select Month. Enter the brief description of your work which was assigned to you by your reporting officer in the last month. There is a 1000 characters limit, so within this limit you can write your paragraph which may include lists within it. In the next box, you have to enter the total number of days you have spent in the office throughout the month. Next, you have to mention number of days you worked in the field. Next, number of visitors attended. It may vary from employee to employee, department to department. You have to keep your record while performing any duty or activity, and you have to update your record from time to time. Next box, number of grievance redressal camps attended. If you have attended any grievance redressal camps, mention the number, how many days you have attended the said camp. In the next box, you have to enter the number of grievances attended or resolved. Next is physical targets achieved during the month. How many targets you have achieved during last month, you have to mention the number here. Next is if there are any financial targets achieved by you during the month. Next, any significantly higher achievement and contribution thereto, you can mention within the box, keeping the 500 characters maximum limit in mind. And lastly, you have to click on the submit button. Your reporting officer will review your report every month. There will be a separate dashboard for reporting officers. They can view the reports of their subordinates. Activities will be assigned grades out of 10 with different color-coded schemes. That is all about today's video. Do subscribe, like, and share this video with others. Thanks for watching.